So tonight's theme for the concert is actually all Disney stuff. And you know, it's kind of a shame because I realized about halfway through the quarter that it's May 4th and we're not doing any Star Wars stuff. So I love Star Wars, so May the 4th be with you, by the way. But we're not doing any Star Wars stuff, but we are doing all Disney stuff. And we are doing, however, this piece is called Once Upon a December, and it is from Anastasia. And they have told me, and they said, Mr. Fenton, this is not a Disney tour, but Anastasia was apparently adopted as a Disney princess. So she's a Disney princess now, I guess, right? Yeah. I don't keep up with this stuff. But anyways, so this is Once Upon a December. And the words and music were written by Lynn Arons and Stephen Flaherty, and it was arranged by Audrey Snyder. Because I pronounced her last name wrong like for the first like 2 weeks. And so every morning I would go, Olivia, how do you pronounce your name? She would want me to go, Ashley. Every time. I was like, keep telling me, I just want to get it right.
No.
All right, so three solos here, Olivia and Emma Painter and Arrington Chapman. So this is A Whole New World, written by Al Menken, arranged by Ed Wojcicki.
Back to where I used to be. But now I'm
So seeing this as this is our last concert, tonight we're also going to be acknowledging all of our seniors in each group as they perform. And tonight we have one senior in our choir, which is Lily Mule. And so I wanted to share this a little bit about what her plans are and her history with our choir. So Olivia has been in choir for 2 years, and she has found it to be pretty fun. Olivia has been taking music since fifth grade. She started with orchestra, and then band, and guitar, and finally choir. She won't be continuing down any music-related path in college. However, she'll be majoring in computer science at ASU. Olivia will still be keeping music in her life, even if it isn't in her education anymore. And we're so happy to have you. And it's been great to have you in class. I appreciate having your guitar as well. And Olivia will be receiving her honor chord at graduation as well. So let's give her one more round of applause. Our final piece for you from choir tonight, before we take a quick break to change over the stage for orchestra, is called Homeward Bound. It was written by Marta Keene and arranged by Jacob Althaus. And we have a solo tonight song by Mackenzie Moak. And her mother is over here, Krista Moak, on her piano. So let's give Ms. Moak a round of applause as well. She does this purely out of her heart, so we really appreciate your help, and we thank you so much. We really appreciate you. Don't wait.
Yeah.
All right, so this is Homeward Bound, and then there will be just a short little break while we move the risers back and get all the chairs out, and then we'll move on with our next group. All right, so Homeward Bound, here we go.
Misty morning, when the moon has gone.
I
Right, thank you so much for your patience as we transition the stage over. So this is our concert orchestra, and they are comprised of mostly freshmen and sophomore students. Intermediate level orchestra. They're going to play two pieces for you tonight. The first one is Viva La Vida, which is by Coldplay, and that is arranged by Larry Moore. And the second one is a hip hop tune called A Flat, which is also arranged by Larry Moore. That was originally composed by a group called Black Violin, which is a hip-hop group. So they are going to play those two pieces for you. We have short transitions, but we can combine orchestras, and we'll have combined pieces for you as well. So this is Viva La Vida.
Thank you. Thank you.
One more round of applause, please. I think there's a word. Do you have any teamwork to stand up? And then teamwork should move on up. Alright, so the first piece for you tonight from the Chamber Orchestra, which is comprised of mostly juniors and seniors, with a few sophomores thrown in, is called Kingdom Dance, and features Megan Moran on the violin. It was written by Alan Menken, again. and it's arranged by Robert Longfield. Continuing the Disney theme, we're going to now play music from Coco. And this was written by Chris Anderson Lopez and Robert Lopez, and it was arranged by Larry Moore. So it's now for our time for our senior acknowledgments for Chamber Orchestra. And yeah, we're going to clap around. We have three seniors in this group. Coley Bucker, okay. So Chelsea, maybe we can sit. Yes, Chloe sees. So Chloe's been playing violin for 9 years, and she was in concert orchestra her freshman year, and then she's been in chamber orchestra ever since. Her favorite memory in orchestra is going to Chick-fil-A after each festival. And if you didn't know, we have a running joke in our orchestra that we should be sponsored by Chick-fil-A because we've sponsored them enough. because we go to Chick-fil-A after every festival, so we have a running joke about that. Chloe plans on studying dental hygiene after high school. Yeah. All right, next we're going to do Avery. Stand up, Avery. Avery Hasselstein has been playing violin for 9 years as well. She's been in chamber orchestra all 4 years. She came in as a freshman. She's planning on taking classes. She says, it's hard to choose a favorite memory, but I've had the ability to meet my best friends in this class and create memories that I will never forget. Also, thank you for putting up with me and Chelsea's jokes. You're welcome. Chelsea. Chelsea has also been playing the violin for 9 years. She's been a member of chamber orchestra for 3 years. She came as a sophomore. She plans to go to school to become a dental hygienist as well. And her favorite memories are meeting some of her best friends, Chick-fil-A after festivals, and making jokes in class with Chloe and Andy. So our final selection from Chamber Orchestra for you tonight is Beauty and the Beast. It's a medley of Beauty and the Beast. And we have two solos. We have Shane Butler on cello. And Tina Bobbin on violin. And so this was written by Alan Mankin as well. And this arrangement is by Kelvin Custer. So while they're getting set up, I'll just go ahead and tell you a little bit about our guitar program here. So we have two classes here at the high school where I teach guitar. So we have an introduction to guitar, which is the lower level class, and then we have an advanced guitar class, which is our guitar ensemble class, and that's what this is. So in an introduction to guitar, we just learn all the fundamentals, learn how to read music, how to play the basic chords, a little bit of music theory, not a whole lot. And then we, once they get to the advanced guitar level, we start diving into ensemble skills. We talk about what it looks like to rehearse professionally, working with other musicians, which guitarists don't usually get a whole lot of experience doing because guitar is such an outlier instrument, and most of the time they play solo. So getting a chance to collaborate with other musicians is a great experience for them. And we also learn advanced techniques. So in our second piece tonight, which is the Pirates of the Caribbean mashup, you can actually use some artificial harmonics, which is an advanced technique that I taught them how to do. It's very, very difficult and super fun. And I remember when I first handed them the music and I said, yeah, this whole session is artificial harmonics, they looked at me like it was absolutely insane. And they said, what are you thinking? I said, this section right here is just a glimpse into my crazy brain. Because I decided one day, let's just do this whole section of artificial harmonics. I thought it would be super fun. And it was. And once they got it, they were very, very excited. They're like, if we nail this, is going to be amazing. I was like, what do you mean? If you nail it, you're going to nail it. You'll be fine. So they're going to perform three pieces for you tonight. And the first one is called You've Got a Friend That Means from Toy Story. And it was arranged by a YouTuber called Acoustic Trench, which is the channel, Acoustic Trench. And then I arranged it for a guitar ensemble. So we're going to present to you You've Got a Friend That Means. Thank you. Alright, so the second piece that we're going to perform for you is a Pirates of the Caribbean mashup that I arranged, and it features two themes from Pirates of the Caribbean. The main one, which is called He's a Pirate, and then features another one that we really thought was really cool and isn't featured as often, and that's the Davy Jones theme from the second movie, I think it is, where he's playing on the organ. So this is Pirates of the Caribbean mashup. So before we play our final piece for you, I'm going to do my senior acknowledgement for this group, and that would be Kate Olson. So Kate Olson's standing in the room. So Kate's been playing guitar for as long as he can remember, and he was in my class freshman year, and I remember every year after that, he said, "Mr. Pinch, I'm coming back to guitar." I said, "Okay, Kate, I'll see you then," and then every year he wasn't in my class. And every year I was like, "I wonder where Kate is." And then finally in junior year, at the end of junior year, he goes, "Mr. Pennington, I'm for sure in your class next year." And I said, "I really ready to be for real this time, because I just stopped believing at one point." And then the first day of class, he was there. I was like, oh, I'm so glad. So it's been great to have Caden. And Caden's plans after high school include serving a mission for his church full time. And when he finishes with that, he's going to study business in college, and he wants to become an entrepreneur. So we wish you all the luck, and it's been great to have you. Thank you. Well, all right. So our final piece for you tonight is Under the Sea for Little Mermaid. We have had so much fun learning this piece, haven't we? My favorite memory of this piece actually is one day I got a wild hair and I said, let's go outside into the courtyard. They're like, yeah, the weather's so nice, you know? And so we go out there and we got all of our stuff, and the one thing we don't have is clothespins. And so we're sitting out there in the courtyard, and every time the wind blows, a page of music just goes whoo, like that. And so I'm watching them struggle through Under the Sea, and gosh darn, they were doing their absolute best to get through. And they found some very inventive ways to keep the music on the stand the whole way through. We had absolutely so much fun learning this piece, and they learned it so fast. I gave them the music, and they learned it so fast. I'm so happy. So this is Under the Sea, and it was written by Abba Menken originally, and then I arranged it for Guitar Ensemble. So this, by the way, I just want to say thank you so much for coming. I was so ecstatic to hear how many tickets we had sold, even though it was a free ticket. And if you would like to give a tax donation to our program, you can do that on the J.O. Combs website, jocombs.org. This will also be available. We're streaming on YouTube right now, so it'll be available to watch later on my YouTube page. And I did send that out as well. I sent an email to all the parents earlier today with the YouTube link, so if you'd like to go back and watch it, please feel free to do so, and I hope you do. So thank you so much for coming. We really appreciate all of your support. Thank you to all of our government board members and our administrators and custodians and accompanists and all the students for making my job fun. It's been an interesting year. I'm so happy that we were able to give you at least one live concert, and the kids have worked so hard all year, even on the virtual concerts. They worked their little butts off the whole time to do the absolute best they could through everything that we dealt with this year. So thank you very, very much. Here's Under the Sea. Thank you. Thank you very, very much for coming. We really appreciate all of your support. Have a wonderful night. May the fourth be with you. See you at the next one.
Chairs, stands, and get the risers put away. So, because I get the platform.
The risers out for tomorrow. For
not the choir risers, we have the platform risers.
Bye, Devin.
Different set of risers.
We have so many.
Yep.
We
sure
stop
do.
Stop the live stream. How do I stop? That's
a good question.
End stream.
You're saying no.
End stream. Stop streaming. Yes.
No one that's on YouTube.
Yes.